Hello, welcome back to Let's Play King's Quest II, Romancing the Stones. I did some exploring off-screen and found that... Sure. I need to get closer. The bracelet, with tiara, rather, sorry, is, buried in a graveyard, but not necessarily this graveyard.
You climb back into the decrepit rowboat, and the shrouded ghoul ferries you back across the lake.
Alright, so I have to go in reverse now. No, okay. Didn't remember exactly. Yeah. We have to go back to... the church. Water is no obstacle for King Graham. King Graham don't care. Out of my way, tree with roots. Okay. Here is where we found another graveyard.
Your heart beats faster and faster as you push on the handle of the church door. It opens, and you nervously step inside.
Wow. Okay.
This place of worship has changed somewhat since you were here last. Now it would appear to be a place of ritual, and that sermons have little to do with anything.
Good time to save, actually. looking around.
Evidently, someone stands at the center of this symbol. As you can see some hair on that part of the floor. You see a book sitting on the altar. It appears old and worn.
The cross has been taken down.
The crucifix has been removed from its original place of prominence and now leans at a careless angle against the wall. A large tapestry now adorns the wall behind the altar. The image on the tapestry bears a depiction of some kind of ceremony or ritual. It is somehow reminiscent of the room you are now standing in. You know for a fact that there is nothing behind the tapestry except wall. Though you would like to see the crucifix restored to its rightful place within this church, it is too heavy to move by yourself. You look over the book. It is a journal written by Lowulf, head monk of the Church of Kalima. Flipping through it, you see a paragraph with a name you recognize.
It is frustrating, as always, dealing with Count Kaldor and his ilk. He is just like his father, perhaps even worse. He insists that Kalima be pushed forward to enlighten the peasantry. Can he not see that this path leads to ruin? How can the people retain their moral goodness if their minds are filled with knowledge of the wider world and all of its sin?
You turn a few more pages and choose another interesting-looking paragraph.
I do. I am quite convinced that Kaldor is so blinded by his so-called vision for Kalima that he cannot see the folly of his intentions. And yet, he is the Lord of Kalima. To publicly refute him would create confusion and anger in the people. I am a man of patience, the greatest gift his grace has granted me. Perhaps time will settle this young lord's idealism and grant him sense in the process.
The journal largely contains many entries of similar types and of daily matters of a monk's life. You are about to replace the journal where you found it, but your eye catches a most peculiar passage.
One more for the road. A wonderment was discovered in the forest this night.